Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming channel, so another Valiant Force video. So, as you might already know that I am an F2P. As you can see here, my first time purchase bonus is still here. It means I didn't spend any single dollar in this game, okay? So, actually today I just finished all of the campaign 100%. Basically, to get 100% campaign mission completed, I need to clear chapter 20. And we don't have campaign 21 yet, probably, because it is still great. So once you beat stage 29, then it is basically the end. Are you sure? So beating stage 29 is actually like beating the final boss of the campaign mode. And yeah, obviously we still have the chapter 2010, but this thing are kind of optional. You can do it, you can also choose to not do it, because I think this is just like an extra challenge. Because the reward is basically only gold. So as you can see here, I defeated these stages, not all of them with 3 stars, but the easy one, which is the one that I need to farm this kind of material, most of them I beat them with 3 stars, because not all stages are difficult. Most stages are very simple. We only need to beat 5 enemies that in front of us. Like, you can do it really quick. But some of the stages are kinda long and you have to move very carefully to beat the boss, like the stage 20 and 9. Yeah. What now? After I beat the final chapter of the campaign mode. So obviously, other than doing the campaign mode, we still can do arena, right? And at this moment, we have the Capture the Flag Arena event, and obviously the skirmish mode. Yeah, actually, if you only do it 3 times in a day, it's kind of difficult to enter the top 1000, because I think there are more than 1000 players actively playing in the arena. What I mean is, you can actually replenish the stamina energy 3 times in a day. So if you play it 6 times in a day, every day, and if you are keep winning every time, you can enter the top 1000 quite easily, I think. Yeah, basically I beat this stage 20 and 9 with level 110 characters. Once you beat the chapter 20 and 9, you will be able to access the level 120 feature, which I already did to my Madeline, like this, level 120. So I think one of the next things that I need to do is to raise my characters into level 120. And once you beat the chapter 20 and 9, you will be able to access the next level of weapon upgrading, which is the awakening. So now we can awaken the weapon and we can get 2 random substats and also unlock elemental damage bonus. Yeah, my Madeline is light, right? So if I able to unlock the one with light, it means my Madeline will be able to do more damage with this weapon. And the other feature is transmute. Basically, by doing transmute, I can change or update the status that I got from the awaken. Yeah, like this. If I use this scroll, I will be able to change the element bonus from this into one of these. That's basically it. And also, once you clear the chapter 20 and 9, now we can raise the weapon level into level 70, like this. But yeah, we are going to need a lot of golds to do this. And the status boost is insane, so yeah. It is like the end game feature at this moment, because who knows, they are going to update the campaign mode, right? Like maybe chapter 21, 22, and so on. So other than raising the character's level into 120, upgrading the weapon, doing the arena, the other thing that we can do in this game after we beat the final campaign is finishing the academy missions. By clearing this, we can get this leveling up job materials. It is actually quite energy saving if you do this, because this basically will help you to raise your other characters to higher level faster, because you don't have to farm 50 guardian relics anymore spending stamina from campaign. So what is this heroic trials? So once you clear the stage with 3 stars, you can rechallenge the stage and switch on the heroic mode. Basically, once you beat this, you will be able to get another gem bonus by clearing the stage. Okay, other than clearing the academy missions, the other thing that you can do after you clear this, 100% campaign, is clearing the mess that we made before. I mean, you know, we cleared the previous stages with 1 star, 2 stars, or something like that, right? So after we raise our characters into level 120, raise our gears into level 70, I think it is going to be much easier to get full 3 stars or 4 stars on the previous stages, because the previous stages are kinda designed to beat with the lower level characters, right? Not 120, maybe level 100, or maybe level 90, or maybe even 80. So they are going to be much easier to do. Even some of them are auto battle-able once you hit the max level and you revisit that campaign. So after you did all of those things that I mentioned, obviously the very end game is waiting for the new event, right? So they are actually actively adding new events in this game, and by far they have different kind of events, so the new events are kind of something that we can wait for. And the very last thing is waiting for a new strong character in the gacha that we can use in the arena or maybe on the campaign mode if you need them. I'm an F2P, right? So actually I haven't used my either right to raise the rarity of my SSR characters into 4 stars yet. All of my SSR characters are still 3 stars, as you can see here. This Jenny is 4 stars because we can get her for free, and we can promote her for free to 4 stars if you clear the quest and stuff. Felix, we can get his shards from the campaign missions, right? And Alice is the same thing. Very close to 5 stars actually. Maybe if I get all of those shards, I'm going to be very close to 5 stars. So when the game first launched, there were many people actually complaining about the promoting system, you know, the one from 3 stars to 4 stars and 5 stars, because we are going to need the shards from the duplicates. Well, that's basically not only the way to raise the rarity of the character. You don't really need to get the duplicate from the gacha, because it is going to be very difficult for F2P, because that is actually why people were complaining, especially F2P players. But actually we can farm this aetherite like quite a lot every day. From this shop we can get 2 for free every day, right? And from the airship expedition we can get around 4 to 6 every day, and we still can get the R and SR shards easily from the airship expedition chest. You can get 3 chests in a day, and 1 chest usually contains 5 random shards. But eventually, if you keep playing the game, most of your R and SR characters will be 5 stars, so you only need to focus getting the SSR aetherites in the shop. So at this moment, I have 886 aetherites. I think it is kinda enough to raise one of my SSR characters into 5 stars, but I don't think I'm going to need that yet, so I'm just going to keep saving it for maybe something in the future that is very OP. And usually the main thing that you want to raise the character's rarity, it is because of the aura skill combo. Because once you raise the character's rarity, it will be something like this, the aura bearing. There will be 3 arrow pointings, okay? If it's only 3 stars, there will be only 2 aura bearings. This what you can get from raising the character's rarity, other than getting extra stats and also leveling up the skills. Because you will get skill level up if you raise the character's rarity. Something like this, level 2. The one on Madeline was level 1, right? Like this, level 1. So all I can say is, if an F2P can reach the endgame and you will have the same level 120 characters with the same max level gears as those whales, the difference is probably the character's rarity, which I think don't really matter much, because if you use them in arena, what you fight is the enemy's AI. And basically you can outsmart the AI quite easily in an SRPG like this, because it is all about tactic. You only need to think about what is your next move and outsmart the AI. I think that's all. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe if you haven't, and see you next time. Bye, wishy bunch.